Hello friends, in this video we are going to see how to apply series and parallel connection concepts of the resistors in order to solve a problem where a battery is also connected and we have to find out current given by that battery whenever the structure of the circuit is a bit different. Let's consider a simple example once again. Let's give the value to the resistors and battery. So I'll consider the battery is of 6 volt and the resistor values, let's take this as a 3 ohm, 2 ohm, 6 ohm, 1.5 ohm. Okay. And the objective is to get this current given by the battery 6 volt. So the objective is current given by the 6 volt battery. So the concept is that the 6 volt battery is connected between these two points. So our job is to get equivalent resistance between these two points. So you have to get the value of RAB. That is the first objective. So you have to use the series parallel concepts. So we discussed that whenever two resistors are forming a loop, whichever way, those two resistors are always in parallel. So if you see carefully, this 2 ohm and this 6 ohm are forming a loop. So 6 ohm is parallel with 2 ohm. The equivalent is given as multiplication of two resistors divided by addition of them, and the value you will get is 1.5 ohm. Okay. Now we have to think how the circuit will look like now. So we discussed that whenever two resistors are in parallel because they are forming a loop, whenever you are writing an equivalent or drawing an equivalent, one of the resistor you have to plug out. So what I will do over here, I will plug out this 2 ohm. So in the original circuit, if I remove the 2 ohm, I will get the circuit like this. 1.5 ohm as it is, 2 ohm I plug, this I will keep as it is, 3 ohm also as it is, and rest of the part of the circuit not going to change. So if you see properly the difference between these two circuits, one of the resistor I have removed and whatever resistor I will get, that will be equivalent resistor. So out of this 2 ohm and 6 ohm, I plug this 2 ohm and the equivalent resistor I will draw, which won't be 6 ohm, it will be the parallel combination of 6 and 2, and that will become a 1.5. So this is 1.5 and rest of the part of the circuit will remain as it is. Now the problem will become simple, okay? Because it's a clear cut, 1.5 and 1.5 are in series. So 1.5 plus 1.5, you will get the answer 3 ohm. So these two resistors will become a 1, simply a 3 ohm resistor. And this 3 ohm untouched, and it will be connected to the 6 volt battery like this. Now again you have to apply the concept, this 3 forming a loop, hence in parallel. So 3 parallel 3, answer is 3 multiplied by 3 divided by 3 plus 3. If you solve, you will get an answer 1.5 ohm. Now, out of all of them resistors, I have replaced one resistor between A and B where battery is also connected. So the circuit will look like this. There is a battery between this A and B point, and the value is 6 volt. Current given by battery is like this, and equivalent resistor between A and B point we reduced into a 1.5 ohm. So now our job has become very simple. By Ohm's law, I can say I equals 6 divided by 1.5. So current given by the battery is 4 ampere. So the problem is important because here we have to apply the concept of if two resistors are forming a loop, then those two resistors are in parallel, and whenever we are redrawing the circuit, one of the resistor you have to neglect, keeping other resistor as it is with the value equal to the equivalent of the parallel connection. Okay, and at the same time, irrespective of any geometry of the circuit, the concept will remain as it is. That means it could be a circle, it could be a triangle, it could be a rectangle, but without that, irrespective of that, you have to keep in mind the concept. So for these two purposes, the problem was very important. Okay, we will see more numerical based on this in the subsequent videos. Thank you.